What is 6 red rods divided by 2 red rods? This is the same question as how many groups of 2 red rods are in 6 red rods? Well, here we have 6 red rods. Notice how we have 1, 2, 3 groups of 2 red rods, which means the answer to both questions is 3. For part B, what is 6 white rods divided by 2 white rods? Which is the same question as how many groups of 2 white rods are in 6 white rods? Well, once again, here's 1, 2, 3 groups of 2 white rods in 6 white rods, and therefore both answers are 3. For C, what is 6 purple rods divided by 2 purple rods? This answer is the same as how many groups of 2 purple rods are in 6 purple rods? Well, I think we probably know the answer. Here's 1, here's 2, and here's 3 groups of 2 purple rods, and therefore, once again, both answers are 3. And then finally, D, did it matter what color rods were used to solve 6 divided by 2? The answer is no, because rods of the same color are the same size. And we can use this idea when dividing fractions. In this table, we're given several quotients involving fractions. In the next column, we'll write the quotients so the fractions have a common denominator. By doing this, the parts or pieces are the same size, which is similar to having rods of the same color or rods of the same length. And this should make it easier to determine some of the quotients. After we do this, we'll model the quotient using fraction bars, then write an equivalent quotient problem without fractions, and then finally give the quotient. So first we have 1 divided by 1 half. We want to write 1 in fraction form with a denominator of 2, and 1 is equal to 2 copies of 1 half, or 2 halves. So let's write this quotient as 2 halves divided by 1 half. We know 1 divided by 1 half is asking how many copies of 1 half are in 1. In this form, we're asking how many copies of 1 half are in 2 halves. Well, because the denominators are the same, the parts or pieces are the same size, which is similar to having rods of the same color, and therefore this quotient is equivalent to the quotient of the numerators, which is just 2 divided by 1. So asking how many copies of 1 half are in 2 halves is equivalent to asking how many copies of 1 are in 2. Let's model the quotient in this form here. We'll begin with 2 halves. So if this is 1 whole unit, we divide it into 2 equally sized parts or pieces. So here we have 2 halves, and we're asking how many copies of 1 half are in 2 halves, and now we can just count them. There's 1 and there's 2. Notice how this would be the same as starting with 2 and asking how many copies of 1 are in 2. So now we know the quotient 1 divided by 1 half equals 2. Next we have 2 thirds divided by 1 ninth. Let's write these fractions with a common denominator. Let's use a denominator of 9. So we'll multiply the numerator and denominator of 2 thirds by 3. So the quotient is the same as 6 ninths divided by 1 ninth. So asking how many copies of 1 ninth are in 2 thirds is the same as asking how many copies of 1 ninth are in 6 ninths. Again, because the denominators are the same, the parts or pieces are the same size, and this quotient should be much easier to understand. We should be able to recognize there are 6 copies of 1 ninth and 6 ninths, and therefore the quotient is 6. This is the reason why when the denominators are the same, we can write an equivalent quotient using the quotient of the numerators. So 6 ninths divided by 1 ninth is equivalent to 6 divided by 1. Let's model the quotient in this form using this fraction bar here. Normally we start with 2 thirds, but here we'll start with 6 ninths. Let's cut the bar into 9 equally sized parts or pieces. Notice 6 of them are already shaded to model 6 ninths. And now we can count the number of copies of 1 ninth and 6 ninths. There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 copies of 1 ninth and 6 ninths, giving us a quotient of 6, which is also 6 divided by 1. So now we know 2 thirds divided by 1 ninth is equal to 6. Now these next two examples are a little more challenging. We have 1 ninth divided by 1 third. We're asking how many copies of 1 third are in 1 ninth. Because 1/3 is more than 1/9, we should recognize this quotient will be less than 1. Let's write the fractions with a common denominator. Let's use a denominator of 9, so multiply the numerator and denominator of 1/3 by 3. This is equivalent to 1/9 divided by 3/9, which is asking how many copies of 3/9 are in 1/9. This is not an easy question, and this is where, once we have a common denominator, the equivalent quotient without fractions becomes very helpful. Notice the quotient of the numerators is 1 divided by 3. So asking how many copies of 3/9 are in 1/9 is the same as asking how many copies of 3 are in 1. We should recognize that 1 divided by 3 is equal to 1/3, which means 1/9 divided by 1/3 equals 1/3. Let's verify this quotient using our model. We begin with 1/9, and we're asking how many copies of 3/9 are in 1/9. So let's also highlight 3/9. So here's 3/9. And we're asking how many copies of 3/9 are in 1/9. And notice how only 1/3 of a copy of 3/9 is in 1/9, which does verify our quotient is 1/3. Now for the last example, we have mixed numbers. Let's first write these mixed numbers as improper fractions. The first improper fraction will have a denominator of 3. The second improper fraction will have a denominator of 2. And now for 1 2/3, the numerator is going to be 3 times 1 plus 2, which is 5. 1 2/3 is equal to 5 copies of 1/3, or 5/3. And now for 1 1/2, the numerator is going to be 2 times 1 plus 1, which is 3. 1 1/2 is equal to 3 copies of 1/2, or 3/2. And now we'll write the fractions with a common denominator. Let's use 6. So multiply the numerator and denominator of 5/3 by 2, and the numerator and denominator of 3/2 by 3. So here we have 10/6 divided by 9/6. So asking how many copies of 1 1/2 are in 1 2/3 is the same as asking how many copies of 9/6 are in 10/6. That's still not an easy question, but now because the denominator is the same, the parts or pieces are the same size, which is the same as having rods of the same color, we can easily find this quotient by determining the quotient of the numerators. So this quotient is equivalent to 10 divided by 9. Well, 10 divided by 9 is equal to 10/9, and therefore 1 2/3 divided by 1 1/2 is equal to 10/9. 10/9 is an improper fraction. Let's also write this as a mixed number. So we'd have 10 divided by 9. There's 1/9 in 10, subtract, the remainder is 1, and therefore the quotient is 1 1/9. So while normally we only reserve obtaining a common denominator for adding and subtracting fractions, here we see it can be very helpful when dividing fractions.